President Muhammadu Buhari has ordered the Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC, to pay its scholarship beneficiaries studying abroad. The order comes barely 24 hours after the abandoned students protested at the Nigerian High Commission office in London. As regards the NDDC contracts, the Minister of Niger Delta Affairs, Godswill Akpabio, has named two former governors of Delta, James Ibori and Emmanuel Uduaghan, as beneficiaries of the various contracts awarded by the NDDC. The duo has denied taking contracts. Former Governor Ibori urged Akpabio to calm down, while former Governor Uduaghan challenged Akpabio to provide evidence towards the accusation. Joining me to discuss this are two public affairs analysts. I'll start with Alistair Wilkes. Thank you very much for joining us.
Well, thank you for having me, Felicity. It's nice to be with you this evening.
Always a pleasure. We are also joined by Lanre Suraj. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. Good evening.
Good evening to you. All right, let's start with you, Mr. Wilkes. The presidential directive is asking him to pull all stops to pay the NDDC scholarship beneficiaries by the end of this week. Why do you think it took a protest to get this reaction?
Well, that is the unfortunate situation that the Niger Delta has faced all this while. The Polar Niger Delta has always had rocked up by their own people, not by the federal government or any other clan, but by their own people. And it's unfortunate that it will take a protest for the students that are under the scholarship of the NDDC to get paid. Rather, the NDDC, rather than concentrating on their core mandate, goes on the spending and the corruption spree, begin to spend on things that is not their mandate. Imagine them spending on COVID and leaving the students that they have all sent abroad to go and study in such a jeopardy. It's gratifying that the president responds immediately because of the protest and embarrassment. It's an embarrassment to the government, it's an embarrassment to the country. So for the president to respond, that shows how responsive this president is and does not take kindly to things that are meant to be done by its officials. So it's, I'm gratified, and I think I will give kudos to the president and shame to all those that pretend over Niger Delta and has brought that institution to this unimaginable shame and disgrace. I give kudos to the president for this regard.
All right, let's talk to Mr. Suraj now. What bothered you the most about the students' protest at the Nigerian High Commission in London, even as the commission undergoes deep financial scrutiny?
My bigger worry is not just about the students that are protesting, but my worry is how the mentality of Nigeria, an average Nigerian public office holder, is so skewed that when even appointed or elected into office, what you have is about selfish interests. I mean, look at what was budgeted in the NDDC. Going to graduation program. And meanwhile, the students that are expected to graduate were not paid, but people were paying themselves to go for graduation programs. And the money for graduation were spent where there are actually no graduates. People are just so heartless. People are just so reckless and so inhuman. And I would kind of depart slightly with my brother, Alistair, because it is not just about Buhari waking up and saying, oh, go get them paid. He has appointed people into office and they are representing him. So we would praise him for the good one and we hold him responsible for the bad ones that are done by people that were appointed by him into office. So for me, it is a responsibility of not just the NDDC administrator. It is the same thing for also the president as well.
All right, let's come back to you, Mr. Wilkes. The former governors, Uduaghan and Ibori, both have denied the allegation. Uduaghan, like I said in my preamble, asked Akpabio to provide proof of the accusation that he's leveling against them. My question is, do you expect a correction. He actually used the word, Uduaghan asked Akpabio to correct himself. Maybe it was an error. Do you expect a correction or a clarification? What is your thinking as to what we should expect in the coming days? Mr. Wilkos, can you hear me?
Well, I do not. Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, did you get the question?
Yes, I can hear you. I can hear you. I can hear you.
Oh, go ahead then.
Yeah, sure, I did. Yes, I don't expect anything other than a denial from any of the persons being mentioned.
Okay.
Exactly. Because in Nigeria, nobody has accepted responsibility. No official of government have accepted responsibility for anything that they have done wrong. None. Because most often than none, they use cronies. I expected that Akpabio will have published the entire full details of the owners of those contracts, not just mentioning names. They took this contract through companies. Now, and those the documents submitted for those contracts are still in the file of NDC. So what I expect Akpabio to have done is to have published to the entire world, to the entire country, the content of those documents. They should have published the documents in respect to how those contracts were. Just name them, because they would deny it. Right now, I understand that a lot of people are beseeching the Corporate Affairs Commission to either change names or to change the identities of the director of those companies. Those companies, those contracts were given to companies that have directors. At the time these contracts were given, who are directors of those companies? Who are the promoters? Those things should be published. Because I ask everyone Akpabio has mentioned has denied. You heard that James Manager has denied. You heard that Ojis Okalu said he took contract but he was not paid. You heard that Mwabushi has denied. So that is the bane of Nigeria. Everyone denies what they have done. And what they do, they go behind the scene to begin to want to patch up things or want to get something changed along the line. So that is the bane of Nigerians. I don't expect anybody to come up and say, yes, I took those contracts. I expect them to deny. Nigerians can go a step further now by publishing those documents and let Nigerians see the documents, the CAC documents, and at the time these contracts were taken. Let's see the contract. Let's see who signed for them. So these are the things. No governor of the Niger Delta will deny he has not taken contract from NDDC.
Well, it's they obviously possible. Are, Mr. Wilkos. They are. NDC they're saying when, that the allegation.
NDC was formed.
Mr. Wilkos.
Second, they've all dominated board members into NDDC. So they are all part and parcel of NDDC.
Mr. Wilkos, they both have denied that they had any contract with the exception of the former Abia State Governor, whom you mentioned, who wrote a letter and said a response and said that he actually appealed to the NDDC, who awarded contracts to people that he is not part of. And he is also saying that the contractors are yet to be paid for their contract and that he would not be deterred from helping attract further development. At least he's the one that we know for now that is acknowledging that he had any interaction with the NDDC when it comes to contract. Mr. Suraj, I want you to react to that. What do you think? We have three people, two saying, no, we did nothing. One says, yes, I spoke to the NDDC, but I have no contract in my name.
Yeah, so starting for the last person who admitted, I completely agree with Alessa. You even the ones that are caught with their hands in the cookie jar, they will deny ever being near or even seeing the cookie jar. So with Ojis Okalu admitting that he spoke with NDDC, nobody is expecting to see a contract with the name of Ojis Okalu, but you would know that they are beneficial owners of some of those contracts that are issued. Once he spoke with them, it will be he's going to tell us, yes, I spoke with them, but I was refused the contract. And then he would mention the contract and would see the beneficiary of the contract. It's only when we can believe it. I doubt if there will be any governor in the Niger Delta that has not benefited from NDDC. NDDC is seen by all the governors and the political leaders of the South-South as an extension of any of the states, which they have completely annexed. And for them, it is not different from any of the states. So go and see the parlor state of many of the states in the Niger Delta, of how much they have deprived the people, and you only see the governors, the political appointees, living a luxurious life at the expense of the ordinary. It's the same thing with the NDDC. And like I said, all the political leaders in the South-South are culpable. I have not seen any one of them before now that has stood up to say NDDC is corrupt and also challenge leadership of the NDDC. Rather, they are all potential aspirants to either the office in NDDC or install their protege that can funnel contracts in NDDC to them. So all the denials
have acceptance. With all you're saying, Mr. Suraj, what would now be your take from the latest coming from the Senate on how the IMC of the NDDC spent an amount of 3.175 billion naira on coronavirus in the Niger Delta within 2 months? What stood out for me in that report was the over 35 million naira expended on refresher training on COVID-19. I mean, COVID-19 is brand new. Refresher training, yeah. The correlation. What is your thinking on this?
You, everybody will know up till now that almost every contract under NDDC are just complete joke. There's nothing that would happen. A refresher course on COVID-19. Who are the beneficiaries of the refresher course? I mean, that being organized. For which state? And what was the state doing? I mean, allowances are not paid to doctors and medical workers in many of these states. That has not been done, which will be verified. But what you always get are those phantom expenditures and budget lines that are easily used for diversion. I mean, part of the thing, within this period, NDDC allegedly spent money to also deal with Lassa FIFA. Where you don't have Lassa FIFA cases in the Niger Delta. I mean, these are the most ridiculous things. But if it remains under this usual political statement of saying somebody got contact, you know, another person didn't get, it becomes a joke and it continues as such.
So all right, the NDDC is not keeping quiet. Mr. Suraj, we don't have much time, so I would like you to speak on this quickly. The NDDC is not keeping quiet. They are responding. The Director of Public Affairs, Charles Odeli, is reported in the news as saying that they suspect that after skimming in the past 4 weeks failed to achieve the purpose of sacking the IMC and, you know, stopping the work of the forensic audit exercise, the people are now out again to heat up the polity. Is this the case, do you think? The response is given to all of these latest from the Senate and the scholarships.
Well, I mean, the Senate is capable of making, of converting this to the drama as usual. And the experience we've said before now is that you've really not seen any tangible result from many of the public areas, except the entertainment. That greets quite a number of them. But we were talking about holding people accountable. It is not just about contracts awarded or money disappearing. It goes to people. So we need to know the people. And we need to see the law enforcement agency, you know, deployed to deal with every person in IMC, contractors, in government office, ministers who are responsible, not just with movement of the money, but even the breach of the procurement process and approval.
All right, Mr. Suraj, thank you very much for sharing your thoughts with us on the program. It's appreciated.
Thank you for having me.
All right, we lost Mr. Alistair Wilcox along the line. The network began to act up, so we want to thank him very much. I hope you're watching. Thank you so much, Mr. Wilcox. We'll see you soon enough in the studio when all of this has, you know, relaxed a little. We'll take our plus We'll take a break now. When we return, I'll be giving my take. Do stay with us. A presidential directive coming after a protest by the bright minds of the Niger Delta, who have been compelled to do menial jobs far away from home in order to survive, isn't much in my estimation. The way the NDDC treats her charge is a reflection of the leadership and the overall work they claim to be doing in the Niger Delta. And for me, that really doesn't seem like much. Let me say one thing tonight. Eradicating corruption is a myth, especially with the way we're going about it, but it can be checked and discouraged. Next generation is watching. Let's try to be better in guiding and molding with the actions we take in governance and leadership. I hope you're watching. I hope you listen. Thank you, as always, for your time. I'll see you soon enough. In the meantime, you can catch previous conversations on PlusTV Africa's YouTube channel. Bye for now.